call me Professor Pumar, but you can call me PP.
By the way, know what time it is? It's time to learn about arc lengths. Huh. How am I supposed to work without paper?
Right there.
Oh, whoa!
Dang it! I want the wall to be green.
I got you.
Oh, what? Oh, and I'm on the left side.
You know what this calls for? Studying arc lengths.
Anyways, my name is Giancarlo Pumar, and I study geometry at Infinity Institute under Mrs. Yelena Jacome. Huh, what was I talking about again? Oh yeah, arc length. So basically, in layman's terms, this is an arc length. I have a circle, and I have an angle inside the circle. This would be the arc length. This portion of the circumference that is inside the angle. So basically,
we'll start with one example, which is the distance. Oh, can you see it?
Kinda.
So there are two types of arc lengths. One is by degree, which is equal to the central angle. Say the central angle is 75 degrees, then the measure of the arc length would also be 75 degrees. And there's also measured in distance. Take that same angle, which if you were given the central angle and the radius, you would have to find the arc length. Okay, so in this example, we're trying to find the distance, or x, of the arc length. Since we know the central angle and the radius, say it's 10, make it inches, or whatever form of measure you would like.
Measurement.
So the formula to find the arc length would be central angle over 360 equals arc length over 2πr. So this would be the basic formula to find the arc length, given the central angle and the radius. So since we already know the central angle is 75 degrees, we would put 75 over 360. And the arc length is a variable, x, for example. So we put x over 2. Since phi equals 3.14, we will use 3.14. And the radius would be 10 inches, so 10. So multiplied 75 by 66.8 would give you 4,710, or what would be equal to 360x. So for basic algebra, you would divide both sides by 360. So 4,710 over 360 equals 360x over 360. That would give you 13.1. So the arc length of this circle would be 13.1. Alright. The second example would be not finding the arc length, but finding the inner angle with the given arc length and the radius. So in this example, we will use with the obtuse angle of x, with the arc length being 9 and the radius being 4 centimeters. So we already know the formula, central angle over 360 equals arc length 2πr. So we will use that. The central angle is unknown, so we'll use it for x. X over 360 equals arc length, which is 9, over 2 pi. Since the radius is r, it would be 4. Okay. So, given, multiply the denominator, and it would give you 25.12 with 9 as the numerator, if you simplify the terms, equals x over 360. And you would do the same for these, cross-multiply. Multiply 25.12 by x, and multiply 360 by 9, which will give you about 3,240. So we multiply, I mean, we divide both sides by 25.12. And on the left side, we would get x equals 129. And since it's obtuse and the central angle is in degrees, we'd make that 129 degrees. Okay, so the next problem will be similar to the previous one. Or we have a circle, and the central angle will be 225 degrees. And the arc length would be 27.5 feet. So using the same formula as before, central angle over 360 degrees equals arc length over 2 pi r. So given the information that we have now, we have the central angle, which is 225 over 360 equals the arc length, which is 27.5 over 2 pi r. Since we only know pi is 3.14, we can only multiply 3.14 by 2, but we leave the variable r, which gives us the 6.28 r. So as we did for the same previous problems, we cross multiply. We multiply 225 by 6.28, but we leave the r. So that gives us with 1,413 r equals 360 by 27.5, which gives us 9,900. So basically, what we do now is we divide 1,413 on both sides. That gives us, on the left side, r. That leaves us with about 7 feet. Before we get the units, and this is what represents the radius.